आवाज आ रही है मेरी?
हाँ हाँ बिल्कुल आवाज आ रही है। अरे लवली,
आप भी आ रहे हो अब?
अरे रोहन,
हाउ आर यू
क्या हाल है तेरे?
चलो फाइनली
एटलीस्ट मैं सही हूँ। तुम लोग बताओ।
नहीं अब बस यही चल रहा है, मैगजीन का काम। अब मुझे लगा कि आप लोगों से बात हो जाए तो मजा ही आ जाए। क्योंकि आपके बारे में मैंने बहुत देखा पढ़ा सुना, आपसे थोड़ी बहुत बातें भी करी है, बट रोहन से मतलब मैंने सिर्फ इंस्टाग्राम डीएम तक आज तक हमारे कॉन्वर्सेशन लिमिट हुए हैं। तो मुझे लगा कि थोड़ा एक साथ हम वी कैन गेट टू नो ईच अदर बेटर एंड इट बी बेस्ट टू डू इट विद यू नो समवन हु इज आल्सो इन अ सिमिलर स्पेस म्यूजिक एंड एवरीथिंग एल्स वाइज। सो या दैट इज
रोहन क्या कर रहा है? तू फीफा खेल रहा है?
ये मैं फीफा तो नहीं खेल रहा, मैं कभी कभी सीएसगो खेल लेता हूँ। काफी खेलता हूँ वो तो मुझे पता है, बट यही है ना मेरे पास टाइम बहुत होता है दिन में।
अच्छा
तो वही मैं सुबह सुबह 7 बजे उठता हूँ।
कोई कनेक्ट है सीएसगो मतलब सुबह से लेके शाम तक the number of people I know who just play CS:GO and एक बार अपडेट आ जाता है उसके बाद तो मतलब लेवल अप करते रहो VR में पड़े रहते हैं लोग पूरे दिन। मतलब even with Sayan I see at like 3 in the night sometimes he's just in the lobby. I'm just like he's just spectating games at some point. I'm just like ये ज़्यादा नहीं हो रहा मतलब तुम थोड़ा मतलब ज़िंदगी में वापस आ जाओ।
हाँ आई मीन समटाइम्स आई गेस इट्स टू मच, बट आई यूजुअली प्ले व्हेन आई फील लाइक यार अब आई कैन नॉट डू एनीथिंग एनीमोर, लाइक आई फील लाइक ओके माय ब्रेन नीड्स रेस्ट, लाइक इट्स अ रेस्ट फॉर मी काइंड ऑफ दैट। मतलब यू लाइक मतलब आई एम नॉट अ वेरी कॉम्पिटिटिव पर्सन ना, तो आई मीन आई जस्ट प्ले फॉर फन, ये ऐसे मजे के लिए खेल रहा हूँ। आई डोंट नीड टू रैंक अप और आई नीड कि नहीं यार अब तो रैंक अप ही करना है। आई जस्ट प्ले फॉर फन लाइक एंड दैट्स बीन ऑलवेज।
एक बार बताओ व्हेन यू गाइस लाइक गेट टू इंटेंस विद योर यू नो कंपोजिशंस एंड प्रैक्टिसिंग एंड एवरीथिंग, डू यू थिंक दिस फीफा सीएस टाइप सिचुएशन इज एक्चुअली रियली हेल्पफुल, और डू यू प्रेफर लाइक लुकिंग आउट लाइक वॉकिंग इन अ पार्क और यू नो गोइंग फॉर अ ड्राइव, व्हाट डू यू थिंक हेल्प्स योर ब्रेन रीसेट बेटर?
गुरु भैया बताओ
यार, तू जा गो फॉर इट। मैं तो क्या आई विल टॉक नए वाले घर में भी आया क्या?
हाँ नए वाले में एक दो बार आया
वहाँ एक बार। हाँ तो एक दो बार आया वो, उसमें बड़ा मजा आता था यार। Talking about that time, I think us vakt na life was pretty intense musically as well, and I think I would wait for those days to get together with these all of these idiots to play some FIFA. Ki kuch aur hum pura din baithte the. I remember hum log subah 11-12 baje start karte the. Jab Rohan ka first year tha, aur second year tha.
Haan, first and, second year, yeah.
11-12 बजे बैठते थे और हम उठते थे शाम को 7-8-9 बजे कभी। बस दैट्स अबाउट इट लाइक इन टर्म्स ऑफ गेमिंग, तो यस फॉर श्योर मैन इट्स अ ग्रेट टाइम ऑफ।
माय ओनली थिंग विद गेमिंग वाज दैट एज अ किड आई डोंट नो व्हाट द सिचुएशन विद यू गाइस वाज, एज अ किड माय पेरेंट्स kind of made me start learning the tabla when I was 4, and then after that I kind of got interested in instruments and I would keep getting some small idhar udhar ke percussions, and after a point you know when I wanted a PS my mother literally said this to me verbatim that listen, you either choose you want more instruments or you want a console, we only have so much space in the house we can't have, and plus the amount of distractions you need to have apart from your studies needs to be limited. So when I got my phone and I could start gaming on it and I got a PSP initially, it was a big deal for me. It was like one of those, you know, cheap thrill pleasures on the side where, you know, music is...
How old were you when the PSP happened?
I was well, in my house when it happened, I was probably 13 or something. So, I mean, pretty young, but like that was my first console, and a lot of consoles had come out by then. So I used to go to my friend's house and play with them and beg my parents for a console for the longest time. And then eventually they were like, you know what, fine. My dad went for one of those quintessential US trips and he was like, chalo, theek hai. Ek le aate hai iske liye, bechare ke liye. Aap logon ke aise koi associations hai ki matlab hame gaming isse pasand hai, otherwise itna intense ho jata hai life.
मेरा बचपन में था, आई यूज टू गो प्ले आउट एंड क्रिकेट कॉलोनी के दोस्तों के साथ, क्रिकेट खेल रहा हूँ या फुटबॉल खेल रहा हूँ, कुछ भी खेल रहा हूँ, लाइक छुपन छुपाई भी खेल रहे होते थे एक टाइम पे तो. तो अभी मेरा एक वो ब्रेक था कि शाम को 6 बजे आते थे, 8-8:30 बजे घर जाते थे, तो एक वो भी काफी सही टाइम था जिसमें मुझे फन आता था. बाकी दिन भर आई डोंट रिमेम्बर व्हाट आई यूज्ड टू डू, बट इंटेंस एक्चुअली हुआ नहीं कभी बहुत ज्यादा, क्योंकि बस ये है ना कि रिग्रेट भी किया है थोड़ा सा कि यार अब इतने टाइम ना खेल के अगर थोड़ी प्रैक्टिस की होती तो फिर थोड़ा और अच्छा होता. रिग्रेट भी किया है ना, इसलिए छूटता भी नहीं है ना वो. तो अब मैं कोशिश कर रहा हूँ कि अब मैं ठीक है जब मैं कर रहा हूँ दैट्स फाइन, बट व्हेन आई एम just playing for the fun of it. I'm not gonna regret whatever I'm doing. I'm doing for fun. Like so it's like that now.
But मैंने एक कहीं interview में पढ़ा था कि अभय ने बोला था कि you know in his house like your parents didn't care that much about your studies and all. It was more, the conversation was more about like politics, culture, sports, music, all of those things. So with you also Rohan, what did your parents at some level you know like पेरेंट्स बोलते ना कि बाहर जाके खेलो पढ़ो ये करो वो करो, तो आपके लिए आप लोगों के लिए क्या था वो यूजुअली, वो मुझे एक दो लाइंस होते हैं यूजुअली जो आते हैं.
आई मीन या मेरे लिए तो ऐसा था कि मेरे पेरेंट्स तो लाइक दे वर ऑल कैजुअल अबाउट इट. माय डैड यूज्ड टू से दैट कि लीव इट, डोंट प्ले, इट्स अ वेस्ट ऑफ टाइम. बट माय मॉम स्टिल सेज दैट डू इट, बट डू इन लाइक डू इट लिमिट. Do it in a limit. So, I mean, that is what makes sense to me. But yeah. Leaving does not make sense. I mean, right. Obviously, dads are a little strict, you know, because they are not there meant to be, but I don't know. It's just their thought process somewhat. So, mere liye aise tha, like, toh main khelta tha because when I used to play, so I used to get so much into it that I forgot everything else. So that was obviously that's my fault. But हाँ, obviously चीज limit में होनी चाहिए. तो अब like धीरे धीरे control किया, and it's control, it was not much of like कि हाँ जब खेल रहा था तब बहुत ज्यादा होता था, लेकिन ऐसा नहीं है कि like I was not interested in music. I was very very much like eager to learn more and listen more somehow. So I mean it was in there in the balance. I mean ठीक है, बट अगर ऑब्वियसली कम होता गेमिंग तो बेटर होता. आई मीन आई डोंट नो, आई डोंट वांट टू रिग्रेट इट अगेन. सो आई मीन इट्स ओके.
हाउ अबाउट व्हाट डू यू थिंक
यार अबाउट द डिस्कशन एट होम? आई थिंक घर पे घर का माहौल ना बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट होगा, बिकॉज दैट्स लाइक वन ऑफ योर फर्स्ट स्कूल्स. लाइक आई people say that
yeah it is,
you know, mother is the first school or whatever your mom teaches is the first school. But I'd like to say that it's not just restricted to your mother. I think it's restricted to your entire household, because when your mom is working, and even if she's not working, you spend a lot of time with your grandparents, with your sister, with your cousins, and you catch on to these small little habits that they have. Like right. I remember when I was a kid, I used to abuse a lot. Like I was 1.5 years old. Then obviously as I grew old, I picked up some good habits as well, which is like my first memory of cricket happened, which is what my it was 99 World Cup. I think I was 7. And my father was introducing me to Brian Lara. Dekh, Pakistan versus West Indies ka match chal raha hai. And he's, Brian Lara just walked in. And Shoaib Akhtar ne yahan maar diya. And I was like, that Brian Lara, he tried Shoaib Akhtar. And then he introduces cricket and all these other things. But my dad really wanted to push us hard. So by the time I was 2.5, 3, he had already put us onto good music. So that continued. Then ek kitab hoti thi, Mr. Khanna ki kitab hoti thi, P.K. Khanna ya O.P. Khanna ki kitab hoti thi. Isme sports ke na sare moments aate the. Historic moments of sports in the last 30-40 years.
Yeah.
So my dad used to get that a lot. Reader's Digest aati thi. And then ek sports ki magazine hoti thi, usse naam bol raha hoon, uspe Rahul Dravid ki photo kaafi aati thi. I remember what was reading that as well. So culturally na aise tha ki पढ़ाई के अलावा सारी चीजें और करनी है और टीवी पे भी we used to have a movie night almost every second or third day, I remember. And Star World पे हमने उस वक्त 150-200 बारी टर्मिनेटर देखी है और फिर Planet of the Apes then so because of Titanic watching Titanic and Jurassic Park then John Williams music also. So if you are introducing your young kid, this is the importance of good art and culture. Like when you're 7 or 8, right? And if you're listening to John Williams composing music for a Jurassic Park, or if you listen to Philip Glass or someone, तुम्हारे कान ना accustomed होते हैं अच्छी चीज़ के साथ. तो वो environment ऐसा बन जाता है ना, अगर तुम 5-6 साल उस environment में रहो ना, तो तुम उस environment की आदत हो जाती है. तुम्हारी choices भी फिर ऐसे होंगी, तुम्हारे musical choices भी ऐसे होंगी. Whatever I'm playing is the choice that I'm making, right? So that kind of defines the choice eventually. So that happened with me. That's for sure. Good choices, probably good choice.
That's it's really interesting that you say that because मेरे लिए हमेशा मेरे को ऐसा लगता था कि बचपन से ना मेरे घर पे एक रूल होता था कि हमेशा म्यूजिक बजेगा जब सुबह उठेंगे हम तो म्यूजिक बजेगा क्योंकि मेरी माँ भी गाती हैं मेरी मासी भी गाती हैं मतलब वो पूरा एक फैमिली का ट्रेडिशन बन गया था कि सुबह उठते ही या तो श्लोक या कुछ ना कुछ चल रहा होता था जब मैं नीचे जाता था तो मेरे को ना इनिशियली एक गंदा एसोसिएशन हो गया कि बिकॉज सुबह सुबह उठना पड़ता था ना फर्स्ट थिंग यू वुड हियर इज ऑन अलार्म एंड इट्स लाइक वो इफ यू मेक योर फेवरेट सॉन्ग योर अलार्म यू स्टार्ट डिसलाइकिंग इट आफ्टर अ पॉइंट बिकॉज यू नो यू एसोसिएटेड विद गेटिंग अप एंड stress and everything but eventually I feel it really calmed me down at some level because main subah utke niche jaake kabhi kabhi mera test hota tha but koi bandish chal rahi hoti thi kuch hota tha mera dimag usi mein pura you know it used to get distracted with that which I think was really helpful specifically on the days you know I had to go and give an exam or a test or something like that eventually because it just became a part of you know life at home at some level so you know and even while hearing I feel even if we listen to basic Bollywood music or anything or complicated Bollywood music I feel one can just appreciate those certain aspects or nuances more if your ear is a little bit more trained I feel but ye maine actually abhi Sunday ko we had released an article on this Hindustani classical and jazz jisme maine ye likha tha ki with these two genres rhythm is a little bit complicated and so is the melody to follow for the brain compared to say an EDM or a funk or things like that in that this is my belief that thoda to be able to enjoy it to its fullest usko thoda you have to get used to it you have to listen to it a little bit more whether it's Hindustani classical or jazz what do you guys feel do you feel that it is organic or one has to get accustomed to it
what I think is I take genres basically like I won't say that any genre is bad or good but I'll say the melodies in pop music are short in terms to understand and they're like easily understandable and like people can easily repeat them in their minds and like it's like repetitive kind of
right
but it's not the same in jazz and Hindustani classical specifically So I mean, yeah, to actually feel what's happening in Hindustani and jazz, I'll say these two because these are improvised. So I mean these are improvised. So improvise, if someone is improvising, that means it's kind of random. So I think it's difficult for anyone to understand that, because you need to get used to it and also understand the basics of it, kind of key what's happening and where it's happening and why it's happening. So instead of just casually listening to it, for some people, for most people, it's not casual because they are not able to process it. So I mean, yeah, that's what I think. I think the same thing. So I mean, I think Abhipriya will also agree.
Yeah, when I've actually been playing a lot of improvised music recently. Mera phases hota hai na, jaise main jab bahut chhota tha to I really wanted to play the jazz. Then I was like, nahi yaar, funk is my true calling, because funk is what contextually makes sense to me, because funk mein one ka emphasis bahut hota hai. So one is emphasized, and I am a Punjabi. So so I'm saying I could groove to that more, you know what I mean? So that hit me really hard, and I was like, okay, if I can say whatever I want to say in that environment, in that context, it makes sense. But then I realized that funk is nothing but blues, and blues is actually nothing but entirety of jazz is kind of based out of blues. And then there are other people kind of took the movement to another go. But then, like as Rohan pointed out, a lot of people say that it's random. But Rohan will tell you, if you were to ask him seriously, that when Rohan is actually doing the random jam, the random improvisation on a rag, there is a context behind that only Rohan has understood in that oral sort of tradition that he's learned.
Yeah.
He's Ustad Amjad Ali Khan's student, na?
Yeah.
So the thing is, so they know, Ustad Ji knows that इस रात का ये चलन है, ये आगे ऐसे जाता है, ये पीछे ऐसे जाता है, और जब इस पे इंप्रोवाइज कर रहे हो तो कब रूल फॉलो करने हैं, कब रूल फॉलो नहीं भी करने. आई डोंट नो इफ दैट हैपेंस कि रूल नहीं फॉलो करने, बट चॉइस अब आपकी है कि वी हैव डिफाइंड. सो व्हाट इंप्रोविजेशन म्यूजिक इवेंचुअली इज अबाउट, इट इज नॉट लाइक रोहन सेड इट, इट्स रैंडम बिकॉज ही डजंट वांट टू मेक यू फील और समवन एल्स फील बैड, नॉट अनंत, बट यू लिसनर फील बैड दैट. He's trying to say is that context हमें पता है, या context Rohan को पता है इस case में, but Rohan is not going out of his way to tell you कि यार तेरे context नहीं पता, बहुत ही chill मार, तू तो समझ नहीं आएगा. But what I'm saying is that is one of the reasons why people don't listen to this music is because musician context पता है, हमारे साथ में जो संगत कर रहा है उसको context पता है, but शायद audience उस point of view से नहीं आ रही है. सुमित्रानंदन पंत की, ओ भाई तूने सुमित्रानंदन पंत की एक कविता नहीं पढ़ी या स्टोरी नहीं सुनी, एंड टू रैंडमली वॉक इन टू द कन्वर्सेशन यू बी लाइक हू द फक इज सुमित्रानंदन पंत एंड व्हाई द फक शुड आई केयर अबाउट हर, राइट? नाउ दैट्स व्हाट इज हैपनिंग. सो that is the divide I feel among the listener and the audience, because the musicians somehow they are talking about Sumitranandan Pant or Hegel or Charlie Parker or Rafi Saab, but the listener is coming from a different perspective, uska bhi alag point of view hai, which I don't
care. Yeah,
I have a theory about that shit too, but we
I'm going to come to that.
Theory,
meri bahut theories hain, ye sab meri bachpan se.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, everyone has his own theories. I mean, it's good to have it, at least, yeah, thoughts.
अच्छा, तो इसी से एक related कि you know ऐसे काफी दोस्त मेरे college में थे जो नहीं सुनते थे jazz या हिंदुस्तानी classical, और वो मुझे and they were interested listeners, तो वो बोलते थे कि what should I hear first, you know, what should a person who is into this kind of music suggest to someone who is trying to get into it for the first time and eventually wants to actually listen to this stuff and build up to it. Because main matlab Miles Davis bol dunga, but fir wo sun ke matlab agar unka connect nahi hua to fir you know it doesn't make sense. Yeah, main Charlie Parker bol
dunga,
but
yeah, first of all I'd like to say that Rohan is trained in classical. I'm not trained as a jazz saxophonist. I am learning it every day by practicing. And in that context, For me to say anything to anyone is with respect to jazz or something, it's my point of view. So yeah,
ऐसा नहीं है ना
ये just मेरा point of view. And coming back to the topic that you were talking about, कि मैं रोहन I'm taking the first lead here and then you can go talk about classical. I think what I tell musicians is that you look at things that you like. Like if you're a prog rock fan, there is no point listening to Miles Davis as the first influence unless you really want to change your lifestyle and your thoughts completely. You should actually listen to something heavier, jazz fusion, tribal tech sun sakte ho, ya weather report sun sakte ho, and usse transition karna is easier because it's literally like a book. Jazz has chapters. Okay, there is a chapter by Duke Ellington, there is a chapter by Charlie Parker, then Charlie Parker se influence okay. Coltrane, Miles Davis के साथ साथ करके Herbie Hancock, Chick Corea, Tony Williams, उनसे इन्फ्लुएंस होके अब the Tribal Tech वाले, Yellow Jackets वाले, and Yellow Jackets से इन्फ्लुएंस होके फिर अब ये Mark Juliana और the New Age musicians.
Yeah.
So and it doesn't end there. There is a huge category of artists like Sting. Sting was influenced by Jaco Pastorius.
Yeah.
And you can hear that in the music. So what I'm saying is, you should look at things that you're playing. If you're a guitar player and if you're into heavy stuff, and if you want to transition into listening to jazz or some other different kind of music, I would suggest go through the blues or the jazz fusion or the funk route and then get back to Miles Davis. That's first thing. And second thing, I would say that you don't have to like all kinds of music, right? You have to be honest. I would much rather play for an audience that does not really care about jazz than an audience that is like slightly more fake about it and because when you're not aware of the thing that I'm doing, then it sounds like magic,
right?
And it does.
The impact that it might have on you when you don't know what's going to happen, that's what jazz is eventually. Musicians know the context, but they don't know where they're going. And when you are caught off guard, like I've had moments where people are like, dude, I've never heard jazz, but what you did today was great. And I'm playing a funk gig. I'm not claiming to play jazz or be a jazz musician. I am learning to be a jazz musician. But I'm just saying, so it's okay for you to not know as well. And it will happen. But then you have to look at yourself, where you are musically, contextually, what city you're from, and sometimes Shakti, a Zakir Hussain's kind of jazz fusion will make more sense to you because you come from the some gharana. You're a young budding gharana musician, and then you're like, "Dude, Hari Prasad Chaurasia ji ne wo Lotus Feet bajaya tha unke saath. Main ye sunta hu." And then you discover, "Acha, oh shit, you should not, McLaughlin." And then you go about doing it.
I think that was also one of the reasons why they did Shakti in the first place, which is to kind of, you know, introduce this kind of genre to, like, whether it's Indian classical to the international audience or jazz to India, in a more accessible way for both parties concerned at some level.
But they were hated for this, by the way, when they started it.
No, I had that question also. Yeah.
Go on, Rohan, up to bata classical music bata mujhe bhi suna.
मेरा क्लासिकल म्यूजिक बेसिकली व्हेन आई स्टार्टेड माय ट्रेनिंग आई वोंट से आई स्टार्टेड प्लेइंग फ्लूट आई जस्ट स्टार्टेड प्लेइंग फ्लूट आई डोंट नो इफ आई स्टार्टेड हियरिंग इट और नॉट बिकॉज आई डोंट रिमेंबर इट आई वाज लाइक 4 or 5 व्हेन आई स्टार्टेड प्लेइंग फ्लूट एंड दैट वाज माय फर्स्ट इंस्ट्रूमेंट एंड For me, I think hearing, the only music I heard after Indian classical was pop, and our Indian Bollywood music.
Dil mein mere dard
disco. I mean, yeah, sab kuch suna hai. Literally, like sab kuch ye nahi ki consciously laga ke suna hai, but you know your surroundings, when you were traveling from. school traveling to your school van mein radio chal raha hai and you're hearing Bollywood songs and you still hear it, you still remember it, it doesn't matter if you're consciously listening to it or not. So mere liye pop meri mom ne introduce karaya tha mujhe sabse pehle Michael Jackson ka and blues Westlife like you know kind of love songs and all. You know, I mean that was the genre I used to listen to and liked listening to. Also.
Vanilla pop.
Yeah, that. So I instead of listening classical more, I used to listen to this more because I don't know why, but I just kept listening to it. I downloaded all of these in my phone and I kept listening to it. Actual जो listening जो मेरा transformation हुआ, वो हुआ मेरा college में आके, क्योंकि I don't know how and why in some different consciousness I started listening to different kind of music I started listening to other kinds of music, not that I used to like it, but I was mind blown by it. Ye kya ho raha hai, what is this happening, and I was that kind of guy who was always like into mysteries and ये क्या हो रहा है, व्हाट्स द रीजन बिहाइंड लाइफ एंड ऑल. सो आई आल्सो गॉट इंटरेस्टेड इन द म्यूजिक दैट आई डिडंट नो व्हाट्स हैपनिंग बिहाइंड इट. सो आई मीन आई न्यू देयर समथिंग दैट इज आई फेल्ट विद इट एंड लाइक पॉप सुना मैंने, फिर मैंने ऑब्वियसली अद्वैता सुना, फिर ऐसे धीरे धीरे मतलब ट्रांजिशन होता रहा कि मतलब obviously college bands के लिए कि college band में fusion कैसा हो रहा है कि ये ओ Indian classical गा रहे हैं, although I see that the vocalist singing Indian classical and the band is playing all of the stuff that they could. I mean so I liked it. I mean it somehow धीरे धीरे transition हो रहा है. फिर there came Tigran.
yeah
I mean when Tigran Hamasyan, that one musician who changed my perception of music itself. I liked how it's all improvisation. So when I used to think of improvising on my own, I heard him so much that I started to have those kind of melodies in my head. Not the same, not jazz or not anything. His version of मतलब my version of his melodies and his music, and it somehow happened for me. So it's like the transition happened very slowly but also very quickly, because like it was in a matter of 3 years that I started listening to music I never imagined I'll ever listen to. So that was the point when I was like, I'm so happy and I'm so grateful that I started listening to all these kind of musics and different forms. I had already accepted pop and obviously I was trained in classical, so that's all right, but what I explore more of life and more of music that's here on this earth. So that was quite an interesting point for me. So I mean ye hai ki
earth, did you hear earth ki ye abhi bhi mere ko lag raha hai ki
on this
other
earth.
consciousness
अभी या
नहीं नहीं वो दैट इज फाइन, बट मुझे लग रहा है कॉन्शियसनेस कोई और लग रही है मेरे को आज
नहीं. आई एम लाइक आई एम खुश लग रहा हूं. नहीं आई एम जनरली ट्राइंग टू बी हैप्पी.
अच्छा,
नॉट ट्राइंग टू बी बट आई एम जस्ट हैप्पी बिकॉज़ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट.
सो इट वाज अ थिंग, रोहन वाज नॉट हैप्पी. आई मीन एटलीस्ट आई दैट फॉर द लॉन्गेस्ट परेशानी रहता था, घर जाना है, ये करना है, वो करना है.
रोहन,
तुमने कॉलेज के बारे में बात किया तो मुझे कुछ दिखाना है तुम्हें.
It gives me immense pleasure to have known him over the years and to have seen him grow as a musician and also as a person. He is someone who's very honest in whatever he does, be it his music or be it a relationship that he shares with someone. And anyone who has spoken to him before would agree with me that he's very easy to talk to. Like, you can have a conversation on anything, be it music, art, photography, spirituality, philosophy. He's always ready to have a conversation on all of it. And I met Rohan during our first year in the DU music circuit. And I knew him as a vocalist that year rather than a sarod player. I think in his second year he started accompanying music societies on sarod. And it's been a great pleasure to hear him live, and of course his posts on Instagram and all, they've always been so lively, and it's always a pleasure to hear them. And Rohan, I'd like to say this to you, you're one of the most honest, dedicated, passionate, hardworking artists that I've seen in a while, and I've had the pleasure to be in contact with. And stay the same, keep experimenting more and more. I'm really glad that we had that handshake moment, because that's where our friendship started, and I hope it keeps going strong. Take care, and I really hope you reach great heights. I'm really proud of you, and yeah, take care. Bye.
तो ये आपके लिए मैसेज था फ्रॉम मिस गंगा. उसने बोला कि शी टोल्ड मी टू ऐड टू दिस दैट शी रियली मिसेस यू एंड यू गाइस शुड गेट बैक इन टच एज मच एज पॉसिबल. एंड या इट्स रियली इंटरेस्टिंग टू हियर दैट यू स्टार्टेड ऑफ विद फ्लूट एंड यू वर इनिशियली अ वोकलिस्ट इन कॉलेज. एंड आई इनफैक्ट लव अभय सिंगिंग क्वाइट अ लॉट. सो ये सिंगिंग से क्या ऑब्सेशन?
Singing? No, I was not interested in singing at all. You know, I joined the society in Hansraj, and I didn't even know it existed and how it was, like how great it was or something. So, I mean, I just joined, and later I discovered that they are fucking great people. So, especially Hansraj project that inspired me.
They're fucking great people.
So I mean, it's like I really enjoyed what the music they made, and specifically I liked it, and I got inspired from it. So that's the main point. And the later when I joined it, I thought like, okay, I didn't even know ki kya kya exist karta hai ek society mein. कोयर होता है, बैंड होता है, ये होता है, वो होता है. आई डिडंट नो दैट. आई थॉट कि हाँ बैंड होता है, दैट आई नो एग्जिस्ट बिकॉज आई हर्ड एन हंसराज प्रोजेक्ट. वो पता है मुझे बैंड होता है. फिर आई गॉट टू नो कि एक इंडियन कोयर भी होता है, फिर वेस्टर्न कोयर भी होता है. चल ठीक है, मैंने कहा ओके, आई जॉइंड द सोसाइटी, एंड देन दे टोल्ड मी आई एम गोना प्ले इन द बैंड मे बी. एंड आई वॉज लाइक ठीक है ओके. आई वॉज एक्साइटेड बिकॉज दैट वॉज गोना बी माई फर्स्ट फ्यूजन जैम विद वेस्टर्न म्यूजिक इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स. आई वॉज लाइक okay, I have never done this before, so that's okay, I'm going to do it. But Gagan Goel, who was the vice president of a society, asked me, "Tere ko gaana aata hai?" Maine kaha thoda bahut. To fir he took a vocal test kind of ki ye ga ke dikha ki like all. I was able to do that. So he said, "Tu choir mein gaega ab se." So I couldn't say no because chaud thi vice president ki. So that's the moment I started vocals for the society. फिर उसके बाद
बता नहीं रहा. Rohan's entire family, he's from a gharana.
Yeah,
obviously Anant, you know that, but like Rohan used to talk about that. That's where the singing also comes from. सब गाते
हैं. Yeah.
Oh, the main बचपन में गाना, like बचपन वाला गाना. I was not really interested in it, but like I was scared of it. कि ओ मेरा ना गला इतना वो था कि I was not able to reach higher notes, and I was like you know, मतलब I was not able to sing, and I was very conscious about it. So the first the first lesson that I took, it was not a lesson, but more of like ki test me that if I have some music inside me or not. So Staji at his place had called me once just to meet, and it was Guru Purnima. So I was asked to sing, but I didn't know what to sing. So I had learned the first bandish in Yemen. Mm-hmm. That's the tarana basically. This tarana was the first tarana that I had inside of me, but I didn't know how to sing it. He okay. just asked me, just try singing, and I started singing somehow. It wasn't that good, but but it was like the first thing that I started as a vocal. After that, I was scared of it until I got rid of it in college. So, in my family, it was never taught in a very vocal way. Maybe it was, but I was never, you know, asked to ki nahi, you need to learn singing, to learn play.
Achha.
But I was more into hearing it, but not singing, but somehow playing it through my instrument. It was more like that. Okay. So, yeah, so it was the... I mean, gradually I got rid of the fear that I have of singing somehow.
But what does even Abhay mentioned earlier that when initially Shakti started out, you know, they got a lot of flack for what they were doing to these two kinds of music. So this is just generally something that I've seen that, you know, traditionalists were from gharanas and initially, you know, were very, very conservative about how much you can experiment, whether you should even experiment, whether it's okay to experiment or not, and whether you're disrespecting the music. So what was the kind of discourse in your house? Like in general, like I'm sure it was different for you, different for your father. I mean, generationally it changes. So what have you seen any active like shifts in those thoughts, or has it always been open vis-a-vis experimentation and, you know, trying to do new
things?
It
wasn't much into experimentation. Like I don't think it was, it's more like, an individual effort that you will do. So when I used to after living with my joint family, I shifted to Malvinagar and with my dad and my mom. And here's where I was like, I started learning sarod. So before that, I used to play flute, thoda. Mm-hmm. And not very much, but yeah, thoda. So here I was not taught to play something like ki you should play like this, you should play like this. I was just asked to see what's happening. I was asked to listen to music, but also trying to get the essence out of it. Like I you know, somehow it was not very vocal about, like, it was not related to vocals, but it was like play like this and try to get the essence of what is being played. So yeah. It was the most basic training, like very simple training you have, like you have to do like this, like trying to get the essence of things, and be it rag or be it alap, be it jod jhala. And I was just trying to, you know, the difficult thing for me at that time point was when I was going to perform. When I was practicing, that's okay. But the main problem was when I was like conscious of performing wherever, be it in a radio, be it in front of someone. I was very conscious of it. So that was one thing that I had to work on at that time. But even though it's still there, and like it's kind of interesting because, you know, even after getting rid of every fear that get rid of every fear that you have in your mind, you still have it because your perception is not the same. But whenever, like, I think it's like I should have a perception of enjoying it more than just playing it. So I mean, it's it's gradually I have to sound like an essence more like when I heard Ustaji for the first time I was so inspired and it was my conscious decision to listen to him when that started so that's where the thing that I started like singing in my own mind that's when I started singing the things in my own mind and that's how I learned to play on my own I was taught to play but to sing it in my own mind that was the main thing that I had to learn on my own to explore on my own to get the essence of what is being played also so that's where I think I started really learning what is learning yeah
so with me
in family it was all like already there that people thought that I was going to be a musician already like people think that ki I have to play
right
I thought the same way because it was I was not given the decision to choose something else but it was already there and it was already flowing so it somehow became a part of me
yeah.
from the childhood so yeah it's like that
नहीं बट सरोद का मेरे साथ ये भी था कि यू नो आई हर्ड द सारंगी मच लेटर कॉन्शियसली प्रॉपरली बट सरोद वाज लाइक द फर्स्ट काइंड ऑफ फ्रेटलेस इंस्ट्रूमेंट दैट काइंड ऑफ बेंड्स इट्स वॉइस एंड ऑल फॉर मी दैट वाज द फर्स्ट यू नो इंस्ट्रूमेंट दैट आई हर्ड दैट वेंट लाइक दैट एंड इट वाज वेरी फैसिनेटिंग फॉर मी बिकॉज एट सम लेवल यू नो एनी वेदर इट्स द हारमोनियम व्हिच आई हैड हर्ड द मोस्ट सिंस माय चाइल्डहुड और the keyboard or the guitar any there at some level slightly staccato wo jo
yeah.
bending wala situation it's very organic in the sarod wo jo mean
yeah I mean
so I think
actually I you know in my family almost everyone plays the flute so except my dad he used to play sarod also so from that I don't know you know the choosing between flute and sarod that was the difficult part of me because
yeah.
people were saying that choose both
right.
people were saying that your dad also does this so you're also you should also do this but it was not like forced onto me but it was said that ki you should play both and flute and sarod dono bajaoge to acha rahega so I was not very open for it because I actually somehow had an attraction towards sarod somehow
right.
I don't know why I decided that I don't know so I stopped playing flute and I started sarod and after that I rarely touched flute so it was not that I hate it or something like that or everyone is doing in the family but it was more like ki I had an attraction towards sarod somehow because the way it sounded it was very different
yeah
So like the flute is very very vocal instrument like the way it's played it's very like it can catch phrases very easily to vocals so in Indian classical specifically so I mean the difference in experimenting was just like finding the sound of sarod and finding my own sound of sarod like okay everyone plays and I even tried to sound like everyone who I liked Being sarod,
right.
like the first inspiration was obviously Ustaji, and I was trying to sound like him more and more because that's what I hear pleasing.
Right.
So it was I was trying to sound like different people, but somehow I don't know. I just tried. I got satisfaction with my own sound. Not actually satisfaction, but like I got used to it.
Yeah, I mean, if so, anything, I think it's one of the most unique kind of sounds. That I've heard experimentation wise with vis-a-vis Indian classical but also to both of you because you guys both play multiple instruments how helpful
yeah.
is it to play multiple instruments when you're kind of experimenting or trying to come up with new stuff and how does it help in your theoretical understanding as well as your musical you know understanding of what you're playing
pehle abhi bhaiya batayenge fir main bataunga
मैं फ्लूट बजाता हूँ क्लैरिनेट बजाता था सैक्सोफोन एंड थोड़ा बहुत कीबोर्ड बजा लेता हूँ बट हाउ डज इट हेल्प यू आर आस्किंग हाउ डज नोइंग मोर इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स हेल्प
डज इट हेल्प और डू यू थिंक यू नो इट immaterial whether you know two instruments or one, you can make, you know, whatever music.
I think when you listen to a lot of music, you already understand what an instrument is going to sound like.
Yeah.
So if you have a fair idea ki guitar aise sound karne wala hai, so you can arrange your things accordingly. Just for example, I tell you, at the moment I think of a song, I have already thought of the rhythm. And that helps so much more when you can explain the rhythm of your song to the person who's playing it, na? Because that is the, so imagination is what I would say is primary in terms of, or it's the prerequisite to making decent half-assed music.
Right.
I mean, for example, even something like that, if I tell you, so you'd be able to make a bassline which is around more like a flea, but not right. like a Jaco. You would not think like Jaco because this does not work in a Jaco environment. But if I tell you that, I'm thinking of something, but it's not. I'm saying your imagination has to be very clear and crystal. And so with respect to that, I think I know how to imagine as any other instrumentalist. I'd be very honest. Like I can imagine as a guitar player. I can think about guitar solos and tell you that this is how it's. That's how a guitar would go, but saxophone would go like. Something like that, because there's more bebop in a sax player's language. But I'm saying similarly, like a keyboard player will have a very different. That's how a keyboard player. Similarly, a keyboard player is going to sound very similar to a bass player in terms of their soloing. That shit. I'm saying imagination also works if you can't play instrument.
100%. Visualization is key. Like,
absolutely.
Yeah.
I can think of all the bass lines already, and that helps quite a lot. Same for Rohan.
Yeah, this is not the same in Indian classical though, because there are not many instruments. But the phrasing is very, you know, very unique in every, like sitar can be playing ups and downs very quickly. It cannot be like, it can reach the highest notes very quickly and come down as well. So vocally, almost everything can be done. But like in sarangi, has another sound. And it's more like fast tones are not very clearly heard because it's not plugged, and it's more so I mean this unique, there's a little difference in every phrasing and the instruments, Indian classical instruments have specifically. So for sarod specifically, I never tried to limit myself like I'll only listen to sarod being played. If I want to listen to a rag, in my mind, if I want to learn a rag, I don't just listen to sarod. I listen to every possible thing, even vocals.
Sorry,
sitar,
my bad,
flute.
I didn't want you to see my stomach, but I'm putting the laptop on charge.
So yeah, every instrument has a unique voice, and the way it's been phrased. So I mean sarod, like I just thought what came to my mind first instead of just thinking what it be is being played by my fingers on the sarod. And whenever I play, I think of something, like even if any melody that I play, I think of it in my mind as a vocal, as a melody. I just think of it. I don't have like this is the guitar melody or this piano melody or this melody. I just go with what I feel with the melody, and I just play. I try to play it on the sarod. Sometimes it doesn't sound the way it should, because if I'm trying to play funk on the sarod, it's kind of difficult because when I try to play the notes, I mean they're like they I feel that when I don't know anything about funk, but this is what I have learned. There's a slight gap between, there's a bit gaps in the notes. If you like in Sarod, when I play the notes, they are like more like, so it's like vocalist. So I've always been learned to play like that as an Indian classical phrasing. But when I try to implement it in the funk, it's kind of different. But I also try to justify funk in a way and not play that kind of phrasing. So for me, experimenting is like playing different styles, not inspired by any instrument, but most like what's coming into my mind. Because I have heard so many instruments. So, I mean, every kind of phrasing comes into my mind. So when I make a melody, so it's like that. So
about just being conscious about what we're listening to and letting, kind of observing phrasings and how a particular instrument sounds and all. So just, I had one question that, Abhay, you guys have been putting out, you can study this music on Instagram, on Revisit. Meera ek sawal hai aap logon se ki, I cannot study with music on. My mind gets too distracted with music because I get too into the music, like whether even if it's the simplest music. So how do you kind of disassociate if you can, and if you can't, then how do you deal with it?
Don't study.
How do you deal with what exactly? What do you mean? You can't study with music playing in the background.
Yeah, I can't. In fact, mera thoda extra bhi hai ki, there used to be a clock in my room that used to go tuck, 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 tuck. मेरा दिमाग उसी वही सेकंड हैंड में दिमाग अटक जाता था. आई स्टार्ट प्लेइंग
दी. हां तो तू मत पढ़ना म्यूजिक के साथ, पढ़ बस. नहीं दैट्स व्हाई द सॉन्ग इज कॉल्ड डोंट स्टडी दिस, पढ़ ले यार. दैट्स व्हाई द सॉन्ग इज कॉल्ड यू मे स्टडी दिस.
सर या नो बट इन जनरल डू यू गाइस स्टडी विद म्यूजिक ऑन और विदाउट म्यूजिक?
आई नेवर स्टडीड एज मच एज आई शुड हैव.
सेम एग्जैक्टली. Not my liking, bro. Not my field of expertise. Never going to be.
But I know what you're saying. I do remember studying with music playing in the background in school.
But also, I mean, like studying, not just like studying for school or college, but like, when you're trying to concentrate on a particular, you're trying to write something. Or
I don't want anyone around me. I don't want.
I used to listen to music. I used to listen to Eminem. And I used to practice maths because I was weak at it. So that really helped me because maths, words are, when you're listening to song, maybe that's okay. But with music, I could study math. So that was really interesting because that's how I got 8 CGPA and 10th course with maths. That's the only way I could have got 8. 8 is not big, it's fine.
I mean,
for us...
for me also, it's pretty good. But
मतलब काम चल गया ना, बस ठीक है, पास हो गए.
हाँ, but actually उस time पे I don't think हम और कुछ सोच रहे थे कि मतलब कि top करना है. I were you guys like ever aspiring, like मेरे को तो अभी ऐसा कुछ नहीं था. But also same topic से, what is your opinion on lo-fi music? Because I feel there's a lo-fi version of everything now. Like literally, I think I can search anything. Like Rick and Morty had that snake jazz episode. There is lo-fi on YouTube. It's amazing. But what is your view on this? Because again, I can't even study with lo-fi music. So
you want me to say
it's considered something? Very like it's like the pop of jazz music. It's like very like isme kya hai, ye to bahut like repetitive, simple, ek groove leke inhone fast mein
kar diya. Dekho, lo-fi ka janam jo mujhe lag raha hai na, lo-fi ka janam jo hua hai wo hua hai charas. I feel it's coming from a point of view of being high as fuck and being with your friends. Or being in your room. I'll tell you, I had a phase like that in my college time. I was not smoking up, but I was smoking. For a week, I started smoking. And I remember I was in a very dark sort of place in my mind. It wasn't dark at all, to be honest. I was happy, I was fucking... But dark in the sense that I thought it's dark.
Yeah,
and there is a time in your life where you want to be left alone to do things, you know. Just leave me alone, man. I want this light. I want my laptop. And I wanted to play Floyd. And I wanted to play a certain thing. And in a lot of ways, if you go back and listen to Floyd now, you can see that, you can hear it's a psychedelic rock sort of situation.
Yeah.
But if I'm a 70s kid and I'm listening to Pink Floyd, I'm like, dude, what the fuck?
Yeah.
The song is like 18 minutes. It has all of these things. And it is very different. The vibe, Floyd must have created a vibe that you could smoke up to or chill to or relax to, or, you know, just be, yeah, man, I'm taking this shit, you know. And also there's a cultural aspect of, we've been looking up to these rappers and we've been looking up to these musicians from the West, and they're always chilling about with respect to music, and there's that whole vibe has been brought forth in that lo-fi element. And then we all discovered lo-fi with that that Japanese girl studying picture, or spirited away ka, you know, kuch chal raha hai, and us piche lo. So it's very, and it's almost like, bro, I'll tell you something. I have a big theory about this. I can go on and on about this, but I will tell you why this music is actually in fashion or in vogue these days. There is a, I feel there's a contextual sort of disharmony among the youth, and like basically people born post internet and people born before that. Like I'm a 90s kid, 92, and now I am like 28, so I have a fairly good idea about what things were before sort of internet happened. There are people who have a much better idea. But what I will tell you is that when I was growing up, the only people that you could look up to were your Bollywood actors or your sportsmen or shit that was on the news. Like, I mean, whatever it was, like Barkha Dutt ho gayi, Kargil War cover kar rahi hai, 1990.
TV was the main thing.
TV ho gaya. Yeah. I mean, whatever the fuck, like TV actresses, TV personalities. And so we have a very different point of view about these things. The kids who grow up on the internet now, they are culturally and contextually very different. You put them, for them to not go out and play and stay at home, which some of them did, some of them did not. They ventured out into these things which are pretty unknown to us as well. So I can't imagine what the parents must be, the gulf between their point of understanding and their parents' point of understanding. So these kids have been, like, he said, I love Eminem. I liked Eminem, but Eminem was still my era. But we were not heavily into Eminem. At least I wasn't. But I know people my age who will die for talking about Eminem. Yeah. Similarly, the people even younger than him must be fans of Post Malone or some other shit, or like Doja Cat or some other Taylor Swift. Like when Taylor Swift came out, I was like, what the fuck? How is this music getting a Grammy? But then apparently there are people who will start crying if you say shit about Taylor Swift. And I'm saying, I was speaking from just this point of view, dude, what the fuck? Because when you're growing up, you're almost always shitting on something that's new and all. But the young kids, the gulf is so strong. Like, I know of people like who know about so much about the new bit. For them, lo-fi is what Floyd was to us, is all I'm saying. Like, because there is a cultural disconnect between us and them. And they have seen their heroes get down to this shit or dig this shit. Dig. Kabhi bola hai mainne humne kisi ne? I don't remember saying as a kid, dude, I dig this shit. But I say it now because it's part of the lingo. Mujhe to yaad hai, bhai fatafat de de, 5 rupees ka lace de de, ya kuch aur de de, tazoo nikal rahe hai usme se, some other shit. And I'm not saying that era was good or this era is not. It's just that the gulf is so fucking strong. I can relate to someone who likes Ramayan from the 80s. Because there was literally nothing else. But the young kids, now when Ramayana or Mahabharata was being played over and over again on TV, young kids are like, what the fuck is this shit, dude? I don't get this. Why play Mahabharata or some other shit? And unko is cheez se introduction karwai hi nahi gayi. So in that, with that thing in mind, there are a lot of things, not just lo-fi. There are a lot of cultural aspects which I don't think we have a clue that these young people have. And I mean, I am flabbergasted at times at the sight of these cultural references. And like, I am a Michael Jordan fan. And someone kept saying, why don't you get some help? Aisa karke uska meme hai. Get some help. Karke uska koi meme hai. And I had not seen that. When I was growing up, he was kind of passing the torch to Kobe Bryant. And we used to wake up at 6:30, watch, like my father was into like sports. We had not seen this because wo ad air, India mein kabhi air hua nahi. But the kids have that reference now. Yeah. You don't know Michael Jordan. And I said, you know what I mean? Just because you know a meme, you don't know Michael Jordan. And just because I don't know a meme, it doesn't mean I don't know Michael Jordan. Or number his jersey or whatever. So I'm just saying, it's a cultural thing. Being hip, being chill, being relaxed. And that's what it is. You know, it's easy. It's 4.5 minutes or it can go on for hours. And it's just and there's just
but also I think that I mean lo-fi hip-hop is like it's all right, it's less to process, but it's also kind of telling people to not listen to music, like listen to music in a respected way, maybe. Like, I don't think that music should be taken like casually. You should, like, even if it's any kind of music, be it any kind of music, when you listen to it, you should be able to associate some kind of feeling with it because it's emotion. So exactly. I don't think that's the right thing, the way we are headed to right now. Because, you know, like, it's like, you know, in malls, we when we go to shopping malls and we go to places where speakers and music going on, and we just listen to it casually for the vibe of that place. We're not vibing with the music, but that music is doing its job. That's all right. That would happen, but I think that's a little
ambiance,
That's a little. This is what I feel. A little bad direction that we are heading to.
Up to dekh rahe hai, now that's the perspective of someone who's done music for 21, 23, 24 years, however big the city it is. Now, this guy is fucking, he's legendary with his musical ability.
Yeah.
Legendary. Like, I mean, his whole family is like that. Now, that's his point of view. Now, someone looking at this might be like, dude, tu kaun hota bolne wala? And that's what I'm saying. Ye bahut jaldi log, this is a point of view, dude. If he thinks that music is disrespecting his sensibility, it might just be. And a lot of people, I feel as well that who come out to you and say that, dude, there should be no rules in music. Fair enough. If there are no rules in music, then there should be no rules in filmmaking. There should be no rules
any art,
in other forms of art. And you may do whatever the fuck you want, but I think there's a deep-seated problem here, which is not a problem, which is just a reality, and we all have to come to terms with that. The reality is that music for the longest was being done and being run and managed by people who are from gharanas or people who are damn serious about this shit. Music and art.
Yeah.
It was not being done by these middle-class or working-class kids who want to make a living out of it, right? Till about the partition, you had only heard of Ahmed Jaan Thirakwa or Ustad Amir Khan or some other bit, yeah, Bade Ghulam Ali Sahab or kuch bhi. It is only after the advent of like the new age, with Dilip Kumar coming in, with Rafi Saab coming in, with Devanand coming in, with Kishore Kumar coming in, with these songs wala jo aspect hua na, uske baad what happened is our parents grew up to that shit. And they some of them dreamt. Yeah, Rafi Saab ga sakta hu, main bhi ga sakta.
R.D. Berman, the kind of influences he brought.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that translated into the working class waking up to it and being like, dude, I can do this. I might not be able to do what Ustad Amir Khan was that is why someone like इनका क्या नाम था किशोरी अमोनकर जी that is why her point of view has always been I will never sing for films her yeah. point of view was not because that music sucks her point of view was because that is disrespecting what I have done for all of you that's my way of it. She may not tell you that and you don't have to look at Kishori Amonkar as your idol but I'm just saying that is the way she behaves but what I'm saying is when I look at someone like Kishori Amonkar singing vis-a-vis when I look at someone like Neha Kakkar Singh I'm saying the gulf is so big that I'm like whoa what's happening but Neha Kakkar is achievable so for that generation Rafi Saab and Kishore Kumar were achievable and thus you have the singers who did what they did it kept on going on and now you have a whole working class mentality among musicians where musicians choose now to the do same easier things rather than difficult things
right
yeah
you know what I mean? And I'm not saying that's wrong I'm just saying that's the truth why do you think musicians have this one direction on their mind that seedha Bombay chalta seedha hi Bombay you know why that exists because we've been taught from the get go that beta padhai kar fir job mil jayegi तब तो जिंदगी चाहिए और म्यूजिशियंस आल्सो हैव अ पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू यार एक काम करता हूं मेरे को म्यूजिक आता है मैं बॉम्बे चलता हूं उसके बाद तो काम मिल ही जाएगा फिर लाइफ जी लेंगे यू नो सो इट्स ऑल गोइंग टू बॉम्बे इज लाइक अ गवर्नमेंट जॉब इट्स और अ गुड प्राइवेट सेक्टर वाला जॉब व्हिच पेज यू रेगुलरली यू वर्किंग हार्ड आई एम नॉट सेइंग दे डोंट वर्क हार्ड दे वर्क हार्डर देन आई डू बिकॉज़ दे आर फकिंग नॉट स्लीपिंग एट टाइम बट आई एम जस्ट सेइंग इट इज एन ऑप्शन व्हिच डेफिनेटली लीक्स ऑफ me of you know that mentality where you're like dude I'm looking for stability over excellence I'm looking right. for stability over rules so that's just a reality
that I'm reminded
yeah, of I mean the same thing is happening yeah hmm. same thing is happening with people who just want to make music they get inspired from idioms and all I mean that's yeah they just have a laptop and they just start to produce and they think that is the same thing as like someone like they I think the term musician as like musician they call themselves musician I am not saying that they're not but I think that there's something behind that years of hard work years of thought okay. processing and years of you know trying to get that one note right and that one phrase right There's something with that, you know, if you removed all the technology that we have and you just have your instrument with yourself. I think if you find peace in that, this is what I feel it's better and more spiritual for us. Yeah, I mean, instead of just finding like, okay, yeah, this is the beat that I'm going to make it and like, I'm going to post it online. That's it. I'm going to get famous. Mm-hmm. That's all right. That's not wrong.
Yeah.
But... yeah I mean it's not spiritual and I specifically associate things when I feel them they are spiritual right. for me and for and to inspire others for it's like right. that
there's definitely something to note here the right. the important aspect is that Rohan thinks of it as a spiritual experience and now how many of us generally consider spirituality a big aspect in our lives I'm just saying, right. you just wash it off because you've heard Christopher Hitchens or Richard Dawkins talk about shit like religion doesn't exist, this shit doesn't exist, that shit doesn't. I'm a big Christopher Hitchens and Richard Dawkins fan. So I will tell you that I don't believe in religion as such, but I do believe in the fact that religion gave you music, and which is what Neil deGrasse Tyson also talks about. Religion gave you the calendar that you have. Religion gave you the language that you have. And for me to say that religion sucks now, the old traditions suck, and you know, me being a postmodernist about it, that life is better now. Now exists because yesterday did too. That's all I'm saying. So music for the longest was a spiritual experience. It still is with the drugs, and some people say that, you know, I have a spiritual which is what a lot of people talk about DMT and all these other things that you do when you do music after that or you listen to music after that which is what a lot of music is about. They just trance is about that, which is almost like having a spiritual experience, which is fine. I'm just saying what Rohan is actually, or I particularly want to talk about, is the context of the things that you want. If you're doing music just for Instagram hits or some other shit, it will show.
Yeah.
And that is something that I personally also, I don't have a problem with it, but I don't, I'm not going to do that. But I'm not going to teach if someone comes to me and say, yeah, Abhay, what do you think about this shit? I'm going to tell you that, man, if not today and then tomorrow, this whole era will fizzle up. When I was 20, right, I used to think that I'm fucking invincible. And when life actually happened to me post-college or during, life happened to me way before that, to be honest. But it taught me something. It taught me something that, dude, my existence is only going to be here for another 40, 50, 60, 70 years. And there's one thing that I can do well, and that shit is my saxophone. And if I don't learn that well, na, agar main usko acche se nahi nibha sakta na, to shayad main us cheez mein, I will not be able to have the instant need, but proper gratification in the time. And I'm telling you, I'm much more happy now living in Delhi, living in the COVID situation, than I was 6 years ago when I was flying out to Bombay and flying out to these other cities. I still do that all the time. But I know why I'm doing that. Tab na mujhe tha ki do Bollywood, this and that. I'm going to Bombay, Karan Marao sa band shows, you know. And you know, I'm going to be successful.
Yeah.
That shit.
Yeah, I mean, I get inspired from the people I hear interviews. I've heard a lot of interviews of Zakir Hussain. And I've seen him told that his father, Ustad Ala Rakha Khan, has been literally been like possessed with what he had in his mind. Like he kept repeating the, you know, not mantra. It's like the
bowl in his ears.
Padhant hota hai na. So like he kept repeating. Sulate waqt to batate, he kept repeating to himself also, and he was like so fascinated by it. Like his brain is like literally gone possessed. He used to say ki Bhagwan ji ye kya de diya mujhe, like literally kya kar diya mere saath, ki he was possessed so much, and he was so into his instrument and into music that he didn't need anything else to, you know, be happy. So, you know, when spirituality, I think, is connected to happiness, and I think, I mean, if you are happy with doing a lot of things, that's all right, but that may be not spiritual in a lot of sense. But the least things you have to be, you need to be happy, I think that is little
and also spirituality,
like, that is spiritual.
Yeah, he said something very interesting in one
the
of
the least things you use and like you least things you have to make your life better is spirituality. I think, like, God is something else. Like, I'm not talking about God or religion. That is something else. What we can do to make our lives better and someone else's lives better is, I think, is to get less, take less from the world and give more. So like, I think musically this is also kind of possible, but people are like so much into everything that the moment that they're not into their own instruments that they play. So I mean, that's all right too, but that's not spiritual for me. So I think that life can only, like, if you actually leave a spiritual musician with the instrument that they have, they'll be happy the whole fucking life. So that's the love for your instrument. That's the real love for your music. That shows it.
That is beautiful thought. Like, yeah. Bombay wise, Abhay, also I have one video for you also. I'm just going to share that also. One second.
Who has?
I have one video for you also.
Hi, do you remember the time when I lost the Revisit Projects merchandise bag in Bombay? Yeah, that I don't want to do that ever again. Never ever in a million years I would do that. and thank you so much for not killing me. Thank you so much for being super sweet to me, even though, I mean, yeah, that was pretty scary, that entire thing. But yeah, in those moments, I like to think about the times when, you know, you played these little nursery rhyme tunes to Siddharth's baby in a jam-packed room, and that was the cutest thing ever. But yeah, I was still shit scared. And thank God the world doesn't know about it yet.
So ये nursery rhymes का क्या scene था फिर?
अरे यार, thank you for the video भाई. यार so Siddharth is the owner of DX10, the jam pad. And so he just had a baby like last year.
Greenbox.
Those are Greenbox. So and his son was definitely very interested in seeing the saxophone. And उसको नीचे लाया. He was just like a few months old, and he saw the saxophone and he was like enamored with the whole sound and
yeah.
Enamored cool. by everything.
Like, looks like
he was, I don't know. He was shocked in a
अबे आई थिंक आपका वीडियो पॉज हो गया है एक सेकंड
कैन यू हियर मी
या नाउ यू आर बैक या
बक ही
या सो आई मीन आई जस्ट स्टार्टेड प्लेइंग सम गुड नाइस ट्यून्स टू द किड एंड ही लाइक्ड इट
सो बेसिकली यू डिड टू हिम व्हाट अलारका का साहब डिड टू जाकिर जी ऑलरेडी इंबाइबिंग द म्यूजिक
इन जस्ट फॉर 10 मिनट्स जस्ट फॉर 10 मिनट्स डूड अलारका जी तो Dude, I just read Zakir Ji's book as well. But talking about the bag that I lost, I didn't lose it. Isn't that it? Actually, what happened is we had just come. We were going from a gig from the venue to the place where we were living. मैंने अपने पास saxophone था, alto, tenor, both with my mic and this bag, merch bag that I bought. And merch बिक रही थी मैं पहले थोड़ा गुस्से में था. तो मैंने वृंदा को बैग दिया. मैंने कहा वृंदा टेक केयर ऑफ दिस, तू कनु तू विराज और चेतन एक उसमें जा रहे हो ऑटो में, टेक केयर ऑफ दिस. सो वृंदा ने क्या आया एंड देन वृंदा गिव्स द बैग टू चेतन इट्स द मर्च बैग. अब तू मैं और विराज जा रहे हैं बैक टू द प्लेस वेयर वी लिव, सो टेक केयर ऑफ. कूल. चेतन गिव्स इट टू विराज. So, this bag is important. You, me, and Vrinda are going, and like cool man. And again, so they lost the bag, and I don't want to freak out at these moments because you're in a group, and I am supposedly the leader here, and band leader, whatever the fuck you want to call me. And I genuinely want to put things together on this tour, and I have organized the tour single-handedly. Yeah, I don't want to be the one ruining someone else's night. Especially these three people. And I go back to the venue, come back, the bag is not to be found anywhere. And I'm like, nothing's gonna happen. This shit's not gonna fly. It's okay. Nuksan hua hai, jhel le. I was somewhere happy that at least we got rid of the merch.
Also, you go to Bombay, some auto guys will be wearing some revisit merch and roaming around. Damn good publicity.
But this is how good Bombay is, by the way. The auto guy came back from his home 2.5 hours after that. He came back, he's like, "Aapka bag rahega." Maine usko 500 rupees diye. Maine kaha, "Sir, ji, aapne life bacha li hamari, ye wo ye." And Vrinda started crying. Oh my God, I've been praying. This is what Kashmiri Pandit is being about. Ye, tumne dekha, hum religion ko mante hain. I mean, she doesn't believe in God or anything, but she was praying to Jesus. She's from a convent school. Kashmiri Pandit praying to Jesus for a merch bag in Bombay, and Jesus, please get the bag back. Yeah, she used to believe in Jesus and his second coming or whatever for the longest time.
Damn it!
But this happened.
So I'll just wrap it up by just one final quintessential question that I mean, I'm sure a lot of people want to know, and I have to ask also, which is that with this whole Corona situation. You know, generally funding and everything for artists
whether it's government wise or even generally gig wise, is massively gone down. And concerts and everything are happening online, but wo wali feel hai nahi. Plus, you know, it's just, I don't know, if just logically speaking, if there is something on YouTube, then, you know, a person who has to spend money and then go and listen to something on a Zoom call is just going to be like, the recording is probably going to be better on YouTube, etc., etc. All of those things. I mean, it's happened with mom also. They've spoken to her about these things, and she's also trying to find a way around these things. So what do you think is going to be, you know, the near future of these things? I mean, the content creation is increased manifold, obviously, but like, what do you think is the way forward for at least independent artists now?
Rohan, do you want to take that?
See, for me personally, I think that was a good thing that happened because I got to learn. But if I see in a more general and like in the sense that people live on those gigs and people try to make their dreams come true from these, the hard-earned money that they get from these gigs. I think that's a really sad thing, but you know, it's not just about music, you know, corona to sabko lagega agar, you know, agar hoga to. So I do take it in a positive way because I became a vegetarian during this time. That's a good thing. And I think people can learn that it's not just about money and it's not just about like earning, theek hai, but I think I specifically take everything very personal, to every personal level. So I think that was a good thing that happened because humans do need to learn a lot of things, be it in terms of like thoda mother earth ko pyar karna chahiye na. So us sense mein, I think we needed this. This was a needed situation. I don't need to hate on the people that those who died. Even for me, I can get out of my, like, mujhe bhi ho sakta hai at any time and I can like probably be dead. but I think I'll just let it be because I don't want to dis.
Sad
nahi kar raha. Main bas reality bata raha hu because I.
Rohan is a metal, goth metal musician deep down. from saying I take it positively, he went from saying it's positive.
Yeah, I can die also.
But maybe mar sakta hu, mujhe bhi ho sakta hai. So dekh.
Because I really don't care if like I don't care because like I am kind of like I do exist, but I don't like everything exists on every polar. So I'm very neutral about it. So I really don't know what to say. I'm positive also. I'm negative also. But we needed to learn also. But life bhi gayi logon ki. So it's very confusing. So like, kya sochun, kya bolu? I'm kind of neutral about it. So it was good for me because I learned. So yeah, it was like that.
What do you think?
Yeah, dekho, I don't know about humans learning anything because humans, even if they learn anything, who's checking on us? I don't know if there's someone checking on us, if there's an alien or there's God checking on us. So I mean, definitely we should, that doesn't mean we should just behave without ethics and morals. But definitely I agree with Rohan there that there are aspects to life which can change, which can improve. Just say, if you want to care about your planet or whatever it is that you get resources or, you know, whatever it is that Greta Thunberg stands for. I'm not of that opinion that, Corona is teaching us a lesson or some other shit. I think even if COVID gets over, we'll still get back to what being the way we are. Because, dude, if the Crusades, if what happened in the partition, if the world wars couldn't, I mean, they've impacted us, but they didn't change the basic. Did we stop asking for more money? Did we stop asking for more land? Did we stop claiming other people's property? That should
no, we increase in fact.
May have. I'm just saying that these things are, I don't know if there's enough research about it or whatever, or if I have read enough research. I'm just saying that these things are inherent to the human culture because we are more prone to chaos. And I mean, I'm not citing Jordan Peterson because I like him. It's just that I'm saying, I personally feel that I can only speak about Corona and music and how to take this as a musician. And the rest of the world, I can't speak for. So I will speak from the point of view of this person who's done music pre-Corona and post-Corona or during Corona. Is that, dude, if you were not ready for something like Corona, then you're definitely in the wrong business. Because music, even before Corona, sucks.
Music has always been very inconsistent.
Yeah. Music industry sucks, okay? And it sucks big time. Because the problem is that there is no like stability here. Right? And I mean, Corona time is like going back to
like,
bro, I play for him. Even he doesn't have a gig right now. Unless he's playing from his house for some people, some corporate shows or some other shit. But I know for a fact that Shankar Mahadevan would be like, dude, fuck this. I want to play live. Shankar sir thrives on playing live. He likes the audience. He likes the interaction. He doesn't like it. Yeah. He's sitting at home and chilling. He's not of that mentality. But all I'm saying is, unless you're anyone, I'm just saying you can be anyone and still be affected by the changes in the music scene. Because music scene consistent. It's not like a government job or it's not like a stable job. So as a young musician, the first thing that you need to tell yourself is, what the fuck do I want? Do I want money from this profession? If you want money from music, you're definitely in the wrong profession.
Right.
Because unless you figured the commercial music scene out, I have figured it out because I have been at it since I was 13 and 14. I've been playing weddings, concerts, receptions, main ladkiyon ki entry karwa chuka hu, main logon ki exit karwa chuka hu. चाचे मम्मी की सज्जन कोर्ट पे बजा चुका हूँ 10 लोग खा रहे हैं मैंने वैलेंटाइन डे पे लड़कियों के लिए लड़कों को प्रपोज किया है सैक्सोफोन के साथ मैंने माउंटेन टॉप पे जाके लड़कियों को प्रपोज किया है आई हैव डन दैट शिट गुड आई एंड आई एम जस्ट सेइंग द अमाउंट ऑफ कमर्शियल शोज दैट आई हैव डन हैव टॉट मी द सेम थिंग दैट आई सी म्यूजिशियंस विद अ लॉट ऑफ इमोशंस एंड द मोमेंट दे एंटर द कमर्शियल म्यूजिक सीन दे द Either the person inside dies, or they themselves, the person that they were, dies out. Right. Because truly what you actually want comes out when money and all these other things come out. Money reveals who you really are. It doesn't change you. That's all I'm saying. So if you were having a lot of fun with the money that you were having before Maybe. Corona, yeah. and now suddenly the inflow is gone, and if you can't survive that, then my friend, you're doomed because this shit is gonna happen sometime or the other. If not Corona, do you not think that some other shit will happen? I think shit can happen to you. You gotta be ready for that shit. And as with that thing in mind, I tell anyone who's looking for an advice from me, I tell them, dude, don't think of a house, don't think of a car, don't think of any other shit right now. Think of music. How to get money for that is now here's the point. Like a lot of people say, "Yaar, agar main in sab cheezon ke bare mein sochunga to main paise kaise kamaunga?" Glad that you asked that because last I heard you bought a phone for 75,000. But you are asking me to pay for you to make the album. You are crowdfunding your album, but you have a 3.5 lakh fucking recording equipment with a 2 lakh mic. With a 40,000 ka sound card or whatever it is that you have, and you just bought a OnePlus 9000T, which cost like 38, 40, 50 grand. And it's interesting that you ask me to pay for your album. You know, I'm just saying that you can crowdfund your album, but brother, how is that a good tactic? If you don't have money, you should not be able to buy a phone. You should not be able to buy a sound card. You should not be able to afford any of the shit that you so elegantly flaunt on Instagram. So that means you just don't have your priorities set. You want ki main sab kuch kar lu, but mere liye koi aur koi mehnat kare. And that's what I'm saying. So as a musician, you gotta be ready for this shit.
So I think at some level,
be ready for coronavirus.
I think it's some level. Ron said this one line, which kind of summarizes all of this, which is that, you know, as a musician, if you can just sit with your instrument and feel an emotional connect with it, and whatever spiritual connection, happiness, emotion,
not
anything.
Just that, I would like to add to that. I'm saying one should always be practical as well. At the same time, dude, if you don't have money, and if you are going through shit, I'm not saying keep music is Bhagwan.
Mushkil ho jati hai. 100%.
I'm just saying, be practical. Ask for money for gigs. Do session music. Karo, mera ghar aaj tak Bollywood music se chala. Aaj tak. Do I like Bollywood music? Some of it, yes. Some of it, I don't. But for me to go out and say, dude, Bollywood sucks, indie rocks.
That'll be
me being hypocritical. My everything that I own in this house has come from playing cover music. Right, so I have to understand. I'm saying if you're an artist, you have to understand that aspect of music as well. Money will come from shows that you don't wish to do, and satisfaction will come from shows that no one else is going to give a fuck about. And you have to balance that out. I always tell people that I get paid to not be heard at a commercial gig, and when people actually hear me at a club gig, they don't pay for me.
Right, right.
And which is the greatest irony that a musician has to go through. Yeah. And you're telling me that a few months after that, there will be corona situation. I'd be fine, man. Honestly, I'm fine.
Yeah.
It shouldn't affect you. But there are mental aspects to music as well. Like, some people are very emotional. And mental health is again an issue which people definitely should discuss more. As musicians, I totally agree with that. But I'm just saying that a lot of people claim that they want to do music, but they end up spending money on everything. And when it comes to music, they're like, yeah, hum to paise nahi kama rahe. Arre to mat lena yaar 70,000 ka phone. 10,000 ka phone le, 20,000 ka venture sound card le, 50,000 ka laptop le, aur apna music karna shuru kar. 70,000 ki budgeting, main tu mere paas aa, main budget karta hu tere liye. But jhoot mat bolo. Don't be like, dude, I'm gonna fucking enjoy my Mercedes. But when it comes to music, you know what? Just crowdfund my album. That's not a good strategy anyway. How the fuck are you... No one knows who Anant is. But Anant has started this crowdfunding thing where... Chal, theek hai. 100 rupay to tere 500 friends de sakte hai na. Toh ho gai 50,000. Aur usko double kar lo. 1,000. Tera network itna achcha hai ki toh 1,000 logon ko janta hai. Sabne 100 rupay diye. Tere ko 1,00,000 rupay mil jaye. Iski kya guarantee hai ki wo 100 rupay deke tere ko matlab music sunenge tera?
That's true.
What I'm trying to do, I'm not against crowdfunding. I'm not against it. I'm just saying, if you're crowdfunding shit, you should definitely be fucked. You financially. Matlab, because if you can pay for something that you want to be yours, you might as well do, na? Do you crowdfund for your shoes? Do you crowdfund for your shoes? Do you crowdfund for your PlayStation? Phone ke liye crowdfunding kar, paise to main bhi kar dunga. Dude, you know what? I am a musician and I want to go fund me think about this new phone that I want.
Well, I think like protectedness bhi hai jo ab generation ka jo gap keh rahe the na. Well, I think ye protectedness hai hamare, I'll agree, mere mein bhi hai, but I think hamare pure generation is like, when I look at my younger sister and all, even more, कि मेरे लाइक माँ बाप तो निकल गए थे अपने घर से कि हम जाएंगे गांव में काम करेंगे, देखेंगे क्या होता है, उसके बाद लाइक यू नो मतलब कुछ लिए बिना मतलब मैं मेरे में नहीं है कि अभी मैं यहीं से निकल जाऊं और किसी गांव में जाके मध्य प्रदेश में काम करूं 2 महीने तक. आई मीन आई विल प्रोबब्ली गो राइट एन ईमेल ट्राई टू गेट अ रिप्लाई.
व्हाई पीपल डू गो फंड मी वाला थिंग इज वेल निकाल ले तू लगा ले चार्जर लगा
ले एक सेकंड. हां सॉरी. हाँ जी बोलिए.
Why people do the GoFundMe wala thing is, music cannot be seen. It's not a tangible thing. So you can't go to your parents and be like, Dad, we're going to album banani. Haan beta, kitne paise chahiye? Dad, 2.5 lakh rupaye. Abhe, teri bhans.
Exactly, yeah.
Tu 1.5 lakh ki gaadi le le. Wo sahi hai. Tereko main 1.5 lakh ki bike dilwa deta hoon yaar. And then the kid is like, 1.5 lakh ki bike dilwa doge? Music ki baat. म्यूजिक तो मैं गो फंड करवा लूंगा यार, बाइक दो, समझ रहे? एंड इट्स एंड सो इंडियन पेरेंट्स नो हाउ टू प्रेस योर बटन्स डू. आई हैव सीन दिस हैपन टू मायसेल्फ डूड. दे हैव ब्रॉट यू अप, दे विल एंटाइस यू टू एंटाइस यू इन सच अ मैनर दैट यू विल बी लाइक ओ पेरेंट यू, ये तो मैंने सोचा ही नहीं. यार ये तो मैंने सोचा ही नहीं. अच्छा 1.5 लाख रुपए मैं म्यूजिक में लगाऊ और जिसका कोई रिटर्न भी नहीं है, जिसमें पैसे भी नहीं मिल रहे हैं.
गारंटीड तो है ये.
आल्सो इट्स अ लॉजिकल थिंग, इफ यू पुट योर हार्ड अर्न मनी इनटू समथिंग यू वांट इट बैक,
राइट?
सो देन यू गो लाइक यू नो माइट एज वेल आस्क द फैंस टू पे फॉर इट. भाई तुम ही ना सुनना है, तुम ही दे दो पैसे, राइट? फॉर एग्जांपल दैट इज फाइन इफ यू हैव एन एस्टैब्लिश्ड फैन बेस एंड यू लाइक गाइस आई एम शॉर्ट ऑन कैश and 40% the album to fund kar do and people are like yeah man tune hamesha mujhe music free mein diya hai to bahut sahi banda hai, you're god. But if you are sending me a post from New York about how you're supporting Black Lives Matter or some other shit that you think that social justice should happen, and at the next post is can you go fund my album, excuse me, it takes like 2 lakhs to just reach New York. What the fuck are you doing?
Yeah. Circumstances.
I'm not saying some explosive shit. I'm just being very honest.
Yeah, no. That's the least I can. Yeah.
Dude, I spent 12 lakhs on Revealed's album, out of which 2 lakh came from the band's fund. 10 lakh I paid personally. And I'll tell you something. I will never get that money back. Okay? I am not going to be... I'm not Beyonce with... the kind of looks that she has and music that she has. I am not going to get millions and billions of views. I did it because I fucking love music, dude. And also, if there is enough repertoire of my music, young kids will be like, shit, 4 albums hai, ki sunte hain, explore karte hain, there's enough to listen to. And there are hardly any other bands doing that. They should. I'm saying, agar tumhe pyar hai na, cheezon se, to tumhe sacrifice karna padega. वरना भाई घर बैठो तुम्हारे को फोन आ जाएगा, तुम शादी वाली की को जाके वापस आ जाओ. मैं भी वही करता हूँ. वो पैसा रख लो, जोड़ लो कहीं छुपा दो और गो फंड मी कैंपेन स्टार्ट करो. एंड दैट्स व्हाट पीपल डोंट वांट टू प्ले म्यूजिक. पीपल वांट अ हाउस, पीपल वांट टू बाय अ हाउस एंड अ कार फ्रॉम म्यूजिक. दे डोंट वांट टू डू म्यूजिक बिकॉज़ इफ यू वर डूइंग म्यूजिक यू वुड बी फकिंग प्रैक्टिसिंग. डू Do you go to an office and go like, dude, I'm here just for the money, and काम तो मैं करने नहीं वाला हूँ, so you know might as well. But when you get a job, they teach you branches everything, and they can you learn, you know your job inside out. How many musicians and how many singers or how many drummers or how many sax players know their music inside out? They don't. They're there for I'm here to get laid, bro. I'm here to get some other thing, bro. And some other thing, bro. And fair enough, they're getting laid. They're getting everything, man. Kudos to their efforts. Go fund their albums, man.
Okay, on that note, thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much. This was a lovely, lovely conversation. And it was our first such conversation for our In Culture mag. And hopefully...
Kone ho gaya parchan meri baat sun.
नहीं मैं क्यों परेशान होऊंगा, मैं थोड़ा ना हूं.
नहीं तुम कोई भी हो यार, आई एम जस्ट सेइंग दैट यू ऑट टू डू म्यूजिक, अच्छे से कर लो यार.
एग्जैक्टली,
वो ग्राइंड इंपॉर्टेंट
है. दैट्स वेरी ट्रू.
बट अगेन थैंक यू सो मच एंड थैंक यू गाइस फॉर वाचिंग एंड प्लीज लाइक एंड शेयर दिस वीडियो एंड गो चेक आउट आवर वेबसाइट एंड आई एम गोना लिंक बोथ ऑफ देयर वर्क्स in our comment section and our description. Please go and like and follow and share their work. They are amazing musicians and I look up to them and it's great. Thank you so much.
Thank you, man. Bye, man.
Bye.